Get the Terminator.
I wish it was what I thought.
So both of your tweets. So we're here now. Yeah. We're going to talk about Terminator, Dark Fate review. That's my first question. How much of this played?
A lot.
They used the score a lot?
From the beginning.
They used the score a lot, yes. Brad Fidel?
Yeah, Junkie XL mixed it into certain moments.
But it's in it a lot.
Yep.
A lot of people are saying that's the score is their favorite part.
Yep.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Junkie knew what he was doing. You got me so far. You got me so far.
Oh, you haven't seen it?
No, not yet. I skipped out on that.
That's why we brought you in. Okay. Yeah. It's me and you.
So let's hear. Girl. I want to hear John's review first, and then we'll go with Roxy and then I'll ask questions. Go ahead, John.
Okay. I thought it was absolutely stellar. If you're a fan of the Terminator franchise, this is like bringing it back to why you fell in love with it. I see a lot of people comparing it to The Force Awakens in that it's bringing back the feeling of why you fell in love with the original trilogy. This brings back the feeling of why you fell in love with the first two films. It also introduces three great new characters to the franchise, and they all knock it out of the park as actors with what they do. The new Terminator technology is effing freaky as hell. Okay. And then also Linda Hamilton, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Edward Furlong. They're all... Furlong's in it. They're all in this. And I think Schwarzenegger does some of the best acting he's done in decades. And I think it's great that Hamilton is back to reprise the role of Sarah Connor.
Now, she looks a little over the top in the trailers, not so much in the movie.
Not in my opinion, okay. No. Compared to everything that's happening, because the movie just starts and you're on the ride. It's a roller coaster from
Roxy,
beginning to end.
Man. Would you say this is the same page or a little different?
Completely the same page. I love this movie. First of all, I love Mackenzie Davis. I loved her in Tully. Mm. And then if anybody didn't see Izzy Gets the Fuck Across Town, that movie was awesome. Nobody saw it.
But nobody ever talks about her in Halt and Catch Fire.
Old Catch Fire. That's where I found her. She's great.
Excellent. She's just so talented. So she was perfect casting. And if she hadn't been, this might not have worked. Okay. But because she was so excellent.
She makes it work.
Yeah. This was the absolute funniest I've ever seen Schwarzenegger be. He had
But in a good way. Not enough.
Just dry the whole time.
We're not laughing at him like, uh-oh, he's not fitting in this movie. Right. He delivered exactly what he was supposed to, and I was not expecting that. There was a ton of laughs in a really great way throughout the theater.
Tim Miller's directing? How's that?
I thought his direction was really excellent. Okay. I thought that Linda Hamilton was so badass. I won't say what happened because of spoilers, but her introduction is like, everybody stop what you're doing. It's Linda Hamilton.
And that I'll be back moment in the trailer totally works.
Yeah,
in context.
It doesn't work
in the trailer.
It played really well, but what I will say, what I will say is one of my favorite parts about this movie is that the majority of the movie is three women kicking butt, and they never need to acknowledge we're three women kicking butt. It just is. They just are. They're awesome. And it wasn't like, I need to go seek out another woman. It just happened. And I'm going to say there's maybe 20 movies that have ever been made that have been able to accomplish that.
Really cool. I'll throw this in. There are three twists in this movie that when they happen, you're like, oh my God, that's brilliant. Or that's awesome. Or I never even thought that was possible. And so when you see them happen, you're like,
let me jump off that, because that's one of the things I thought Terminator's been missing, is that even though it's the first two are just simple. They're simple premises. That's what I hear this one is. But there is still a fun way that they introduce time, how the post-apocalyptic thing does that very well? Does it set itself up like the original mythology, the Doomsday, all that? And B, does it set itself up for more movies?
I would say it possibly by the end sets itself up for more movies if they want to. But if they wrapped it up here, I don't think anybody would complain.
Okay.
I really don't.
I think that we definitely could get more movies because we're world building, which is cool. I also think that if you've never seen Terminator before, you could watch this movie and enjoy
Great
it.
Point.
Which is good because they need to bring on a new wave of fans.
Right.
And I think that this did a good enough job explaining what's happening without being boring for the people who have seen all the Terminator movies.
I gotta tell you, you guys got me excited for it. I saw both of your tweets when it came out. That's why I wanted you to talk about it on the show. But I've been hoping for a good Terminator movie since the second one. The first one's my favorite. I love the second one, but the first one's my favorite. And I have been looking for, I love this world, and it just has not delivered since 1990, 91, whenever it was.
That's why the tweet saying this is the best since T2 does not do this justice, because it makes it sound like it's good enough.
But it's almost really like a backhanded compliment.
This is way more than watchable. This is a really good, solid, fun, butt-kicking movie.
And don't be surprised if you cry at the end.
Not
be surprised. Right. I certainly got emotional at the end.
Well, I mean, the second one was like that, too. You know?
Awesome.